Never feel disconnected. Several ways that you can share. You know, you can always bring your offering by the church, or you can drop it in the mailbox, or if you want to do it the most easy and efficient way, you can use our Giblify mobile app to do your giving online. But however you do it, we'll always say thank you. Amen. For whatever you share. And we will always pray God's blessings back on you for what you share. Now, my pastor, if he was here, he would say it's preaching time now. And we do have a preacher in the house.
Amen.
We do have a preacher in the house.
Amen.
A very wonderful brother in Christ, who's like the doctor that I wish I had. He always gives me exactly what I need. He don't have to run tests or guess. He always gives me exactly what I need. And he always blesses me in a supernatural way when he stands to speak. And I get excited when I hear that he's going to preach. And this morning, we're going to be blessed by our own Reverend Michael Glover, who's going to come and share with us what God has given to him. So those of us that here in the sanctuary, even those of you watch my social media, let's say amen, and Reverend Michael Glover comes to share with us now.
Giving all praises to God and to my Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Christ.
Amen.
I'd like to give acknowledgement to our pastor, Pastor Early Hudson, in his absence, and to my brothers that are here in the ministry of the sanctuary with me, as well as those who are viewing by live stream or social media. And to you, my brothers and sisters in Christ, if there be any sinner or sinners under the sound of my voice this morning, I greet you all in the name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. For this is the day that the Lord has made, and we shall rejoice and be glad in it. Eternal God, our Father, we come before you this morning. We just want to say thank you. Thank you, God, for your grace, and thank you for your mercy.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, God, one more time for allowing us, Father, to assemble here in the house of worship. Thank you, God, for allowing us, Father God, to have social media by way of getting your word out.
Yes.
Father, we thank you once again for your grace and mercy, love and kindness. We thank you for how you watched over us throughout the night and early this morning. You touched us with your finger of love and your finger of life, God, and you allowed us to journey on a little while longer. And for that, we just say thank you. Father, we come before you right now in the name of Jesus. God, we thank you for the power of prayer. We thank you for the privilege to be able to come before the throne of grace one more time. Now, God, I come asking that you would allow the Holy Spirit to have his way, God, to move within me, God, to speak for me, to see for me, to hear for me, to think for me, God, to move for me. Just use me as the vessel and the tool that you would have, Father God, as your word goes forward. Father, we're praying right now that as your word go forward, that it will go to the saving of souls, to the changing of lives, to you being glorified, and to us giving you the praise, because you're worthy of all praise, honor, and glory. And for that, we say thank you right now. Father, we thank you for your Son, our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, who you gave that we all may have a right to eternal life. Jesus, we thank you for enduring the cross, paying a price and paying a penalty that we could not pay for ourselves. For that we say thank you. Now, God, have your way. Have your way, God. Have your way, God, through me and in this place. For we ask it all now in Jesus' mighty and precious name. Amen. Thank God and amen. Come on, let's all join in and just tell the Lord, thank you. Come on, if you really thank him, just lift up your voices with me.
16. Amen. Amen. Another very familiar
familiar passage of scripture that we all have heard and are used to. And on this morning, our scripture will be coming from John 3:16. Amen. Now I'm asking that you will pray for me and pray with me as I was shared these scriptures. I prayed and asked God that he would give me something to share from those particular scriptures, if he would. And I pray that he has done just that. And I just hope that his word would go forward as he would have it, and not return unto him, Lord.
Yeah.
Amen. For sometimes we might hear a message that we just ain't feeling. But if it not return unto him, Lord, it has done exactly what he wanted it to do. Amen. Amen. Y'all don't have to be so quiet. I know it's not that many of us, but he say, well, two or three or more got together in my name, I'll be in the midst. Amen. Amen. So right now, I think we more than if we had 150 people in here, as long as he's with us. Amen.
Amen.
On this morning, John 3:16, those of you who can or will, if you can stand for the reading of God's word out of reverence to him. If you can't, we understand. God bless you. John chapter 3:16 reads as such: for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. Amen. Thus in the reading of God's word. On today, we're going to use as a subject and for a title for a few minutes, the source of eternal life. The source of eternal life. Very beautiful passage here before us on this morning. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. And I'm not adding to that scripture, but verse 17, right after that, on short, it just says, for God sent not his Son into the world to condemn the world, but that the world through him might be saved. Amen. Amen. A source of eternal life. A source. A source is a place or a person or a thing which something comes or can be obtained. It is the origin of something. Another word that caught my attention along with source was fount. The word fount. F-O-U-N-T, fount. And it says, if you describe a person or thing as the fount of something, you're saying that they are an important source or supply of it. Come on, y'all can pray with me this morning. Y'all can help me this morning. It brought to my mind, there is a fount filled with blood, drawn from Emmanuel's vein, and sinners plunge beneath that blood, lose all their guilty stains. Amen. Don't underestimate the power of a hymn. It just might be those words that can turn one to the source of eternal life. Come on, y'all pray with me this morning. There's a quote that says, bad news travels at the speed of light, and good news travels like molasses. And there may be some truth to that, depending upon the news we share. But I feel that we all like to share good news about ourselves. We like to share good news about our lives and even others at times. We lose some weight and get in shape. We looking all good. That's good news. We might share that. We get a promotion of some kind. Maybe you're getting married or starting a new family. That's all good. That's good news. We might share that. Perhaps even getting a new car or home, and we're just excited. We just like to share our good news. Very seldom do we like to share our bad news unless we're soliciting the prayers of others. And that's all right. Because our source of eternal life is a prayer answering God. But above all that, there is some good news to share that's greater than any other news. And it's the news about the one who has the name that is above every name. And that's about our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. As we have just passed another election time, and to some of us that was some good news. Some people are happy about it, and some people are sad. So some people are overjoyed and some are just plain right mad about the outcome of the election. But let's not lose sight of the fact that God's way always works. He has never failed us. We know that we cannot put all of our trust and focus in individuals, in men or women, but our voices and our choices made and can make the difference in the lives of so many. We should want all to know that there is a choice that one that was made years ago by the one who loves us so, and for the one whom we can put all our trust in. And that choice was and still is Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. In this gospel according to John, in which he is the writer of, John started by letting us know, according to John chapter 1, verses 1 and 2, that in the beginning was the Word. And the Word was with God, and the Word was God. The same was in the beginning with God. Our source of eternal life has been here since the beginning. God loves us just that much. And we have to tell that good news to the world. He was here in the physical, but now he's with us in the spiritual. As I was watching a CNN talk show, there was an interview with three individuals who had not made their choice of who they would elect, who they would vote for or choose for the presidential election. I know that's over with and behind us now as far as the presidential election, but at that time, they still had a little more time. They had questioned these individuals once before, and now this interview that took place this second time was 10 days before the election day of November the 3rd, 2020. Time, my brothers and sisters, of the essence when making a choice for eternity. It needs to be done immediately. My brothers and sisters, some choices in our lives we have to make for ourselves. The three people they interviewed, one seemed headed to one side, but not quite sure, while another was decided for sure. And the third kind of left their choice anonymous. What am I saying? They all knew that their time was running short. So a decision would have to be made soon. Keep that in your mind. Our time is running short. Now this was just for a presidential election time. And during that time that we make this type of choice, it's only going to last at least 4 to 8 years. But there is a decision and choice that should be made that will follow you throughout eternity. Come on, we can give God praise. He did it for us. And that decision is to follow Jesus and make the choice to accept him and believe in him as your personal Lord and Savior. When Jesus' followers started out with him, it's awesome how the Bible shows that once Andrew followed Jesus, he first found his own brother and told him about Christ. And he brought it to Jesus. That's back in the first chapter of John. And when Philip started following Jesus, he found Nathaniel and told him about Jesus. And Nathaniel followed Jesus. Now, if you have Jesus, who are you going to call? Or who are you going to find? Or who are you going to tell about our source of eternal life? Our time is running out. The closer it came to time of voting, the closer it came to the end, the campaigners began to push more and more. They began to push harder and harder to get individuals to choose the one they were promoting and advocating for. And let me be an advocate through the Holy Spirit this morning to encourage someone to choose Jesus for everlasting life. If the campaigners can do it, then I can do it for Jesus. In the beginning of chapter 3, in the gospel according to John, Nicodemus, a prominent Pharisee, a member of the Sanhedrin Council, those who were always trying to trap Jesus. They were more obsessed with man-made rules and the traditions of the fathers. Nicodemus had witnessed Jesus' miracles. And he came to Jesus by night to have a talk with him. Now we have to stop and we have to tell all we can. No matter how you come or when you come to Jesus, it's important that you come to him while you have time. Even if you can't physically come to Jesus. The Bible says that if thou shalt confess with thy mouth the Lord Jesus and believe in thy heart that God had raised him from the dead, thou shalt be saved. For with the heart man believeth unto righteousness, and with the mouth confession is made unto salvation. It is much more important than who was running for the presidency or who's in the White House as we shared thoughts in that decision. Don't misunderstand me. It is important to have the right people there and in the right places. But we have witnessed that doesn't always happen. But yet we have to be the voices for a greater cause. To reach people, to change lives, one soul at a time. Because there is another house we're on our way to. And if you are a part of that we group, it's good news to share and know that we have a building of God and a house not made with hands, eternal in the heavens. We ought to give God praise right there. This is a much more permanent house and place than where we are right now. And since we know how to get there, we've got to tell somebody else. Because just like John the Baptist, who was sent from God and came for a witness to bear witness of the light, that all men through him might believe. Just like John, who was commissioned to be the voice of one, crying in the wilderness, make straight the way of the Lord. We too have been commissioned followers of Jesus Christ to share the good news of Jesus Christ. We have been commanded and entrusted by Jesus to, here's their other scripture, go ye therefore and teach all nations, baptizing in the name of the Father and the Son and of the Holy Ghost, teaching them to observe all things whatsoever I have commanded you. And lo, I am with you always, even unto the end of the world. Amen. Even during a time of pandemic, we've got to reach people, change lives, one soul at a time. If it ain't with one soul at a time, that soul can tell somebody. So they can tell somebody. So they can tell somebody about the Lord. We've got to tell somebody. So they can tell somebody. So they can tell somebody about the Lord. If you've been around a little while, you might have heard the saints of old saying, I'm going home on the morning train. The evening train might be too late. I'm going home on the morning train. Then they would back it up with, get right, church, and let's go home. And I found out that gospel train is a code word sung used in the Underground Railroad by slaves. Often sung just before an escape in an attempt to let all who wished to go know that the time was near. This world is not our home. So we got to tell somebody, so they can tell somebody, so they can tell somebody, and get right, church, and let's go home. For the word of God declares, and Jesus says, heaven and earth shall pass away, but my word shall not pass away. But of that day and hour, no man knoweth. No, of that day and hour, knoweth no man, no, not the angels of heaven, but my Father only. There is a choice and a decision you can make in your life for the rest of your life. And in the end, you will be happy. You will be safe. And you will be secure throughout eternity. And that choice is to accept Jesus Christ today. Why don't we give God some praise? From the statement that Nicodemus made with his meeting with Jesus. And acknowledging him as rabbi and giving reference to the miracles that Jesus had done by recognizing that they were through God being with him. Jesus goes immediately into teaching Nicodemus the more significant thing to his life. It is the more and most significant things to our life as well. And that is that one must be born again. That's not the question. That's not the question. That's not the statement that Nicodemus made. But Jesus went immediately into talking about being born again. Jesus knows, my brothers and sisters, Jesus knows how to meet us at our point of need. We can go to him for one thing, but he already knows how to meet us at our point of need if we'll just come to him. This is a spiritual rebirth. It's a spiritual transformation which comes from God up above. Spiritually, it is God bringing believers to new life from a previous state of separation from him. Although Nicodemus was a prominent, he needed to be born again. Only God's power and not human effort can transform the sinful heart. Only God's power and not human effort can transform the sinful heart. Jesus wants us to know that he is so powerful and authoritative that if we would lift him up and look to him for salvation and put our faith in him, we will have eternal life. And that's good news this morning. I don't know if it's good news to you, but it's definitely good news to me. But we've got to tell somebody else. We just can't keep it to ourselves. Well, in case someone may be wondering or asking and need to know how this is all possible, I'm glad that you're wondering. I'm glad that you're asking your mind, how is this all possible? Because God, by his infinite love for us, his endless love made it all possible. That's how it's possible. God can change anybody. The Bible doesn't show where Nicodemus actually confessed Jesus as personal Lord and Savior, but he was shown the way to everlasting life. So how is it all possible? I'm glad you asked again, how is all possible? We see, first of all, it's possible because God loved. It's possible because God loved. The Bible said, for God so loved the world. So it's possible because God loved. Since you are in the world, you can get a new start in life. Since you are in the world, you are included in this love of God. Charles Livingston Allen was an American ordained United Methodist minister, most notable for his work as a pastor. And he was once quoted as saying, when you say that a situation or a person is hopeless, you are slamming the door in the face of God. Because nothing is too hard for God. Nothing is impossible for God. How, Reverend Glover, is it all possible? It's the second thing we see. It's all possible because God gave. He made it possible because God gave. The Bible said that God gave his only begotten son. How many of us like giving up our very best? I don't think we're going to have too many to volunteer by giving up our very best. How many of us like giving up not only our last, but our one and our only? I don't think we're going to have too many that's going to jump on that opportunity either. Because sometimes sometimes we have a tendency to write people off. But just like the Jewish ruler sent those out to question John the Baptist about who he was, John knew he was commissioned. I told y'all we've been commissioned as well. But John knew he was commissioned to tell them about and lead them to Jesus. And that's what we got to do. We got to tell somebody so they can tell somebody. He knew that he was commissioned to tell them and lead them to Jesus. the Lamb of God, which taketh away the sin of the world.
Come on, preacher.
Well, we're almost at the end. And I know you're wondering, well, what's all in it for me?
Come on.
I told you that God loved.
Uh-huh.
And I told you that God gave.
Uh-huh.
And thirdly, I see that God preserves.
Uh-huh.
I know we're going to have some aches and some pains down here.
Yeah.
I know we're going to go through some pains down here. Uh-huh. But God preserves.
Uh-huh.
The Bible said that whosoever believeth in him should not perish,
uh-huh,
but have everlasting life.
Yeah.
If you believe in Jesus, whether you young, whether you old,
yeah,
whether you tall, or whether you short, whether you thin, or whether you white, whether you heavy, or whether you well, whether you white, or whether you're black, whether you Latino, or whether you're Asian,
yeah,
whosoever believeth in him should not and will not perish.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Although we will encounter various obstacles on this side,
yeah,
on the other side, let's talk about it. On the other side,
yeah,
God will wipe away every tear,
yes,
from their eyes. There will be no more death.
Uh-huh.
There will be mourning or crying, uh-huh, or pain. For the older order of things has passed away.
Yes,
he who was seated on the throne said, I am making everything new.
Uh-huh.
God preserves.
Uh-huh.
So my brothers and sisters, if this subject is a little touchy for you, I can understand. If this subject is just a little touchy for you, I have some good news for us as born again,
uh-huh,
believers. Because I know it's fun when we're talking about living and not dying. It's fun when we're talking about staying around and not leaving.
Uh-huh.
But in Jesus' living, he loved me.
Uh-huh.
In his dying, he saved me.
Uh-huh.
In his burial, he carried my sins far away.
Uh-huh.
In his rising, he justified, free forever. One day he's coming, oh, glorious day. So Jesus says, let me comfort you with these words. When he told his disciples, because I'm leaving you. Let not your heart be troubled. You believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you unto myself, that where I am, there you may be also. And that's good news. I don't know about you, but it's so good news to me. He will come again. So we have to tell somebody, so they can tell somebody, so they can tell somebody, and we can get right, church, and let's get ready to go home. John's gospel is priceless, both for the sinner in the process of coming to Christ and for the believer who has walked with him for many years. When we consider something to be priceless to us, it's invaluable to us, it's precious to us, it's indispensable to us. Jesus Christ is absolutely necessary in our lives. During the time of a pandemic, they always talked about who was essential. I'll tell you who's essential. Jesus is essential in all of our lives. John knew what his mission was, and that was to lead people to a saving knowledge of Christ. And we've got to tell somebody so they can tell somebody, so they can tell somebody, so they can be led to the knowledge of Christ. And likewise, we have to lead the lost to our source of eternal life. And our source of eternal life is Jesus. And that's through Jesus that we'll tell somebody so they can tell somebody so they can tell somebody and we can get right, church, and let's go home. And I don't know about you this morning, but I'm so glad that Jesus paid it all, and all to him I owe. Sin had left a crimson stain, but he washed it white as snow. Jesus is the source of eternal life. And I don't know about you this morning, but I'm so glad that Jesus, God, so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish but have everlasting life. For God sent not his Son into the world to condemn the world, that the world through him might be saved. And I don't know about you gonna be healed in my place. And I'm so glad that Jesus went to Calvary's Hill in your place. And if you don't have it in your life this morning, I want you to know that he went to Calvary's Hill in your place. Jesus, I'm talking about the one who gave his hands to the nails. He gave his feet to the spikes. He gave his side to the spit. He gave his head to the crown of thorns. He gave his spirit to God. He was buried in a barren tomb. Stayed there all night crying. Stayed there all day Saturday night. But early Sunday morning, he got up with all power and help in earth. Nothing better than knowing Jesus. He'll pick you up and turn your life around. You ought to know him. Get to know him right now, today. Just come. There is nothing better, I'm telling y'all, than knowing Jesus. At this time, we're going to open up the doors of the church. There may be one within the sanctuary. There may be one out on social media. If you don't have Jesus Christ as your personal Lord and Savior on today, this is your time. This is your hour. You can get to know him today. I'm not saying you won't continue to go through things. I'm not saying you won't have faith problems in life. But I'm saying if you get to know him, it's better with him than it is without him. And right now, if you take today and come, you'll see exactly what I'm talking about. It'll get better. But there's nothing better than knowing Jesus. I know we're not meeting in a sanctuary, in a full church, but you can still accept Jesus Christ right where you are, in your house, in your car, over your
bold and profound message.
Amen.
You know, I do a lot of channel surfing. And one of the things that I constantly run across is people trying to sell me a product. And they tell me all the benefits that I would receive if I purchased that product. But I've discovered that the only way that you can ever know if something is good is if you try it. So the only way that you're going to know that Jesus satisfies, you don't have to try it yourself. I can tell you what he's done in my life, but until you try, you'll never know. Again, we want to thank Dr. Glover for that powerful message this morning. And we want to thank all of you that have joined us here in our sanctuary, as well as those of you who have joined us by social media, by Special Women's Annual Day. And before we bring back our speaker, we're happy to have the president of our women's ministry here with us. And we would think it would be discourteous on our part if we didn't at least offer the president of our women's ministry, Sister Debra Terry, opportunity to she wants to come and just share a word with us.
Amen.
So let's say amen to Debra Terry. And then after following her, Michael Glover will come back and have a final word and benediction.
Amen.
Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
It's a mighty good day.
Yeah.
I bring you greetings in the name of the Lord.
Yes.
My Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ.
Yeah.
We're living in some unusual times.
Yes.
One more time. One more time.
Yeah.
God has allowed us.
Yeah.
One more time.
Thank you.
To come together to celebrate a Women's Annual Day.
Yeah.
Many started out with us last year.
Yeah.
But they didn't make it.
Yeah.
And we just want to say, Lord, thank you, for allowing us another time.
Yeah.
I'm so delighted to serve in a ministry with wonderful women, with a wonderful group of women. The women's ministry mission statement for this year was reaching people, changing lives, one soul at a time. Ladies, thank you for going over and above in ministry during this pandemic.
Yeah.
I just want you to know your service has not gone unnoticed. Thank you for giving yourself and for being faithful in your giving. I ask, ladies, that you would get a copy of the Greater Emmanuel Women's Newsletter to see what the women of Greater Emmanuel have done in 2020. Thank you, ladies, for a job well done.
Amen.
During this pandemic, several women have faced some tough health challenges this year. And we want them to know we are praying for you. We would like to pause just a moment to remember three women who transitioned from labor to reward in 2020. That was a part of our women's ministry. Sister Gwendolyn Wright, Sister Delcia Wesley, and Sister Terry Robinson. These ladies are gone, but not forgotten. Also this year, we had three sisters in Christ who lost their husbands. Lisa Dunson, Ariester Terry, Sister Donna Henderson. We want you to know that you are not alone. We love you, and we are praying for you. We'd like to say thank you to our program participants today, Sister Dolores Ryder, Sister Brenda Jennings, Sister Tammy Glover, Sister Taylor Hodge, Reverend Michael Glover, Reverend Gary Jackson, and Sister Taylor, Pamela Taylor. Thank you for the Sunday school lesson. Thank you to all of the women. Thank you to all of the officers of the women's ministry. Our vice president couldn't be here today. She sends her love. Amen. She had to go take care of her mom. Then we'd like to say thank you to our pastor. He's not here with us today, but we know that he loves us, and we ask that you continue to pray for our pastor and his family. And before I sit down, I'd like to say a special, special thank you to the best financial secretary on this side of heaven, Sister Sandra Hawkins. She always keeps us with everything we need. Let us know where we are short, what we need to do. And we just thank God for her. Ladies, thank you for your financial support. Now, are you ready for the good news? Are you ready? Thank you. We reached our financial goal for 2020. Give yourself a even during the pandemic, the Lord blessed us. And if it had not been for you, we could not have made it. Thank you, thank you, thank you.
Thank you. Jesus.